Everyone took a real holiday and switched off from the world and from work. Well, for most of us, catching a break is pretty rare. And for those lucky enough to have taken time off from work, we usually still have business on the brain. New research has shown that 30% of Aussies are using their annual leave to simply catch up on their sleep, and around a quarter of us are cutting our annual leave short to get back to work. We're crazy. Why can't we just switch off, and how do we get the most out of our sleep? Well, joining us this morning is sleep expert Dr. Michael Breus.
Hey!
Welcome to the show.
Thank you. I'm excited to be here.
Why is it that we just can't seem to catch enough Z's?
Well, I think a lot of it has to do with the importance that we place on sleep. A lot of people say, I'll sleep when I'm dead, I've got more stuff to do, I've got to deal with my kids, I've got to deal with my partner, what have you. And sleep just keeps getting smaller and smaller because our wake-up time is usually pretty consistent. Yep. We always wake up at the same time, but it's that bedtime that seems to flux. So if people could focus in on a consistent bedtime, they'd probably get a lot more sleep.
So how can we get a better night's sleep?
So there's I have five tips that I give people that people can try starting today, and they can instantly get a better night's rest. Okay. So step number one.
Put my children up for adoption?
No, it's not quite that.
Okay, right.
Step number one is more about consistency, sort of like what we were talking about. Same going to bedtime, but most importantly, same time waking up. Turns out the wake-up time is the most important, the anchor to the whole program.
What about sleeping in on the weekend?
You absolutely, positively should not sleep in on the weekends. And I'll tell you why.
I was with you right up until not.
So here's what happens is you go to bed late on Friday, sleep in on Saturday. Go to bed late on Saturday, sleep in on Sunday. Guess what your brain wants to do on Sunday night? Go to bed late and sleep in on Monday. That's why Monday mornings stink.
Yes.
Right? But if you can stay consistent, your body knows when to sleep, and that's really what's important.
What makes sense?
It's concerning that people are using annual leave to catch up on sleep.
It's amazing, right? Like, people would actually use their vacation time to catch up on sleep, but some people, that's the only time that they have where they're not so stressed out and thinking about so many different things. I mean, honestly, one of the top things that people say to me when they come to my office is, I can't turn off my brain to go to bed. Right? And so that's one of the things that we're trying
to... That's me. I can't turn off my brain. And I have the worst time sometimes sleeping.
And it's
getting to sleep.
And it's very common. It's very common. But there's a couple of things we're going to talk about in a little while about different pieces of equipment, like mattresses and pillows, and how we can help with that. Step number two has to do with caffeine. So caffeine, we all love it, we all drink it, all of these kinds of things. But most people don't know, caffeine lasts between 6 and 8 hours.
Wow.
So I want your last cup of coffee to be at around 2 p.m. That way it's not affecting your bedtime, which is roughly around 10, 10:30 for most Aussies, right?
Right.
Step number three has to do with alcohol. So I got no problems having a couple of glasses of wine with dinner or a beer or two. That's fine. More than two glasses of alcohol, it starts to affect the quality of your sleep. So give yourself about 3 hours before lights out to have stopped drinking alcohol. Remember, there's a really big difference between going to sleep and passing out.
Yes.
Right?
That's so true.
Is this the guy I should be talking to about it? I have a feeling this is the right guy over here. So we really want to be careful about giving ourselves enough time for our bodies to metabolize through the alcohol.
Moving right along.
Moving right along.
With Princess Cruises, you've designed a new bed to help people sleep better. Tell us about that.
So actually, within the steps of that we were talking about, step number four had to do with exercise, right? If you can exercise daily, it improves your sleep quality. Well, you, just like exercise, you need the right equipment.
That looks like a nice place to go.
It was. So check that out. That's the Princess Luxury Bed out on Sydney Harbour. Let's go check it out.
Bed. I love bed.
It's really fun. I want you to hop on in.
Oh, yay. Because do you know when I see my bed, I just go, I love bed. And I never want to get out of it.
So here's what we did.
So what's special about this bed?
So here's what was really cool was Princess came to me and they said, Dr. Breus, if you could start at bottom and just build an entire program just based on giving our guests great sleep, what would you do? And so I literally designed this bed from the bottom up. So here's what's really interesting about the bed is it works for people who like firm, people who like soft. It's got two different kinds of pillows, pillows for side sleepers and for back sleepers. So if you are like the soft mattress with a side sleeper pillow and your partner likes a firm mattress with a back sleeper pillow, you can actually have both in the same unit. So this configures to just about anybody that you could possibly imagine. And here's the great thing is when you go to bed at...
It's so nice.
Isn't it awesome? It's lovely.
I don't want to leave.
You don't have to. You can stay right there for the rest of the segment.
Because pillows, are there pillows I should be going towards?
Yeah, so if you look at the pillows, there's actually two different kinds of pillows. This one's a little squishier. This one's actually the one behind is a little bit firmer. The firmer one is for people for side sleepers.
Yep.
The squishy one is for people who are back sleepers.
Can I lie on the squishy? Because I like
sleep. Absolutely. See, and that's
It's like lying on fairy floss. It's so good.
It's delicious, oh, right?
And is it BYO teddy? Oh. What does the teddy come with?
So I don't know if it, I think the teddy can come with whatever you want. I mean, that is our, you know, our motto there. But at the end of the day, what we're trying to do is, just like with running, if you've got the right shoes on and you've got the right dry fit wear and you're running along with the music, you're gonna perform better. Same holds true with sleep. This is about performance equipment, and literally, it's the best sleep on the seven seas. Nobody out there has done anything even remotely like this, and it's not just the bed. We've actually got tips that people get, a little booklet that teaches them about jet lag. It teaches them what they should do on board. We even have tips around the room, and believe it or not, there's even a channel where I answer the top 20 questions that people have on sleep. So it's an educational experience, along with a lot of fun and really good for your health.
That is so fantastic. How are you feeling, Miss Jess?
Just incredible.
All right. Well, Princess Cruises have got your sleep needs covered thanks to the Princess Luxury Bed on board their Aussie-based ship. So take some annual leave and get the sleep you deserve. To find out more or to book your next holiday, you can head to princess.com. And you can grab a copy of Dr. Breus's new book, The Power of When, online from all good bookstores. Dr. Michael Breus, thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.